What's up, cooks? Happy 4th of July. Today we have a lot of stuff going on in the kitchen. We have the Zach Me made berry cobbler. We got Eric pushing in the slushing machine. He's getting ready to make some daiquiris. We got Deb over here on the dish pit, right? We got all kinds of stuff going on. I hope you're having a great 4th of July. We're starting to cook here at the Amy Learns to Cook Kitchen. There's Eric, right? Happy 4th of July. Welcome to the Amy Learns to Cook Kitchen. Oh my, here's the berry cobbler. It just came out of the oven. I created this cobbler years ago when we first started Amy Learns to Cook. I'll leave a link down in the description to it. It's a very unique recipe in that when you put the batter, your cake on the bottom, berries on the top, sugar, and you flood it with boiling water. And during the baking process, the water absorbs, it goes down with the berries and the cake comes up. It is absolutely fantastic. If you want to make a delicious cobbler, try that one out. Look what I made in here. There's a little potato salad in here. And we got some corn on the cob. Okay, so we have the Vitamix here. And we're going to make this puree, these strawberries, because it won't come out of the slushy machine. The dispenser, if there's any pieces of strawberry. So we are going to
We're adding frozen strawberries to the mix because we like the extra strawberry flavor that you get with that. But like Amy said, it has to be a pure liquid, syrup, or something like that, or else it's going to clog the freezing ability on the thing. Not to mention alcohol is a whole nother level. So this is just an experiment to see, can we make daiquiris in a residential slushy machine? I think you can add more.
Okay, so we have Vivor action here. Here's the slushy machine. We're ready to go here. Eric's gonna put our mixture into the slushy machine. We have no idea if this is even gonna work.
We don't have any alcohol in it yet.
There's no alcohol in it yet because
it's an act as an antifreeze.
Yeah. Alcohol acts as an antifreeze, so it's very hard to use a slushy machine when you have liquor in it.
Well, on a residential machine. Doesn't have the cooling capacity. We're hoping we can add it once it's frozen. We're close to it.
We'll see what happens.
We need to leave a little room for booze. We're close to the fill line.
So what temperature are you setting it at?
Well, it's not a temperature I set it at. This machine has a weird thing. So it thinks we're 1.0 above freezing. This is in Celsius.
One degree above freezing?
And then the compressor just kicked on. We're close to freezing as it is. That ice really helped. So, it thinks.
So one great thing about this is when you're having your party, you just leave it in here and it's hands off.
Right, the problem is you don't say, I want to get it down to 25 or 26 degrees. When you're 5 to 7 degrees below freezing, this thing is crazy. You just need to get a little bit below freezing. 29, 30 degrees is good enough. Of course, it's in Celsius, so God only knows if you're from Canada or Europe, you know what it is. Us Americans, we got bust out our calculators. But right now, it's already a little bit below freezing, but it needs to work. It's going to start scraping and freezing. You can kind of see it's getting a little chunky already. So this may not take that long at all. Our alcohol is in the refrigerator, so it's cool, but it's not freezing.
So next up, we got to form the burgers. I'm making some zucchini. So I'm going to slice zucchini, onions, mushrooms.
So when you say,
yeah, how much liquor do we need to put in there?
You have to understand, a lot of it is going to be ice because it's going to be frozen.
Yeah.
So when you say
and
this,
I'm driving home, so.
Well, you need a couple of hours.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So I'm going to slice the mushrooms and onions. And we're going to move along with our meal.
Forms a thin layer of ice, and that scrapes it off. So when you look in there and you see chunks of what looks like ice, that's because that's freezing. And eventually, you'll have a bunch of ice chunks in there.
So we got big stuff going on here. We have peppers getting ready to be stuffed with little smokies wrapped in bacon.
Little cream cheese.
Got some cream cheese. Deb's over here forming burger patties.
Hello.
Yay.
These are from the...
These are fresh chilies from the garden. I got some lettuce and tomato up here. So here's the slushy machine. It's having trouble. I don't think we have a high enough sugar content because it won't freeze all the way. But it's doing something in here. So we're going to put a little... little rum in there. See that little down there? There's the pan room. We're gonna put a little rum in there and have a good old time with it. Okay, so this watermelon is days are numbered. The next time you see it, it's gonna be in here with that. Wish me luck. There we are, part one. He's cut in half. There's your watermelon. It is completely cut up and it's so tasty. It's so juicy. Look at the juice on it. It's so good.
Mm-hmm.
It's so good.
Good. That is so good. Mm-hmm.
Like water. Fantastic. Yum, yum. Okay, first up, we are sauteing some onions. This is for the burgers and hot dogs if you want some sauteed onion on there. Once these are done, I'm gonna take them out. Then I'm gonna saute another batch of onions for the homegrown zucchini. That's Farmer Ebo's zucchini. The mess is not quite under control, but not bad either. Okay, as you can see, this thing is taking a hit.
It's non-alcoholic at this point.
It's very thick. It did slush. It took a long time for it to slush, though.
Well, we had to get the temperature down to kind of like -6 centigrade.
Put a little bit more in mine. So mine has had the addition of rum. There you go. There's mine with the addition of the yum-yums.
Yeah, she's got some yum-yum juice in there.
We're just filling it up a little bit more. And cheers. Cheers, everybody. It's 4th of July. Now that is tasty. Woo! You knocked that one out of the park, boo.
Pretty tasty.
It's tasty.
Vibe mix is way quicker though.
Yeah.
Very nice. Very good.
You get an A. Farmer Ebu.
Farmer
Ebu.
Cheers, everyone.
All right, we got a little smoker action here. So let's go ahead and open this up, right? Oh, that's crazy. So we have these, can't really call them jalapeno poppers because there's not jalapenos. These are just regular green chili peppers. I think there's a Marconi's. So some have a little paprika seasoning and coloring, some cream cheese, little smokies on there. This is the ones without the cream cheese because food allergies. And then in the middle, we just have stuff that is just the little smokies with bacon. So we'll get a little smoke on this and then this will cook, the bacon will crisp up and it'll be wonderful. So it might take an hour or so. All right, the smoking has slowed down, which is fine. We're just getting a little bit of steam coming out from the water pan that's in there, which is good. So, because you don't want a ton of smoke coming out, because then it'll just taste, you know, like eating tires, right? So we had a little blast of smoke at the beginning. That was some fresh charcoal that I was putting on there. Not to mention, I had some wood pellets. I couldn't find my wood chunks, so I put some wood pellets in there, and then that creates some smoke, but it didn't last long, and that's good. So let's see what kind of looks in there now, right? So, we got a little bit of cooking going on in there, right? Yeehaw. Nice and hot. It's just under 300 degrees in here, which is good. It'll take a little while, but, you know, it takes maybe an hour or so, and then it'll look all good in here. So let's let these babies continue doing what they're doing. All right. I got a couple of turkey patties going for Amy. The rest are beef. I decided to cook up the rest of the beef just because I'm going to probably eat them tomorrow. So let's get ready to flip these babies, right? They've been cooking for a little while. The turkey patties are just a little kind of on the wet side. Amy likes to put look at a little charcoal on it. That's not looking pretty, is it? So I'll probably get some indirect heat on that. So patties are a little on the thick side, so I'll probably give them some indirect heat. I'm just giving them a little bit of flame for right now. And then for a little flavor. And then we'll finish these things up.
We got some burgers going on here that need to get on the cool side.
Get them over there. Looking pretty good, aren't they?
Charbroiled.
Charbroiled.
You need to turn it down a little, boo.
It's charcoal, there is no turning it down.
Okay, well, move my turkey burgers to the over because they've gotten too much heat over there.
They did. No, they're off. They're in the cool area.
Okay.
So we'll do a temp on them in a second.
Can't wait to say that we're like hot dog people, but
we eat them like once a year. This is it.
Ooh, look at that. We got some stuffed jalapenos here.
Not jalapenos.
Oh, they're Anaheims.
These are probably Marconis.
You going to put some sauce on them?
Oh, poor baby. Fell out. We were supposed to have multiple
You going
to
put toothpicks. Some sauce on them?
Yeah, we need a little sauce on them before they go. All right, I put a apricot jam on there, and then I let it sit on here for maybe 5 minutes to just, you know, soak in the warmth and all that good stuff. So I'm getting ready to take it off now. These things have been cooking now for maybe an hour or so.
So we have a slushy. We have chopped watermelon. We have homemade potato salad. We got hot dogs. Avocado for the burgers. This is my firework plates. Grilled onion for the burgers. We got lettuce and tomato. We got burgers. One in there had a little too much fire. And we have zucchini. Y'all ready to eat?
Sure.
Let's go. Let's dig in! That, my friends, is good eating. I hope you had a fantastic 4th of July. You were able to cook and enjoy yourself. Look at my hot dog, nice and charred. There's the zucchini. I'm getting ready to dig in. So I hope you guys had a great 4th of July, and I'll see you on the next one. Mm-hmm.